A servant leader, always pitching in. That's Dr. Bill Wheat, dedicating his time, sweat, guidance, listening to the community, responding to their needs, working for a stronger Southeast Louisiana. Dr. Bill Wheat for State Senate.
Well, Chief Edwin Bergeron had big news when he came to this Hammond-Kiwanis meeting. Namely, the DEA is coming to Hammond.
Look, Ken, that's correct. A while back, I went to the main office for DEA down in New Orleans, and I sat down with their ASAC, which is the Assistant Supervisory Agent in Charge, and we had discussions about the North Shore. We had, for years, people on the task force, and we've had to work with them, and we did a lot of work on the South Shore as well as the North Shore. But, you know, in today's world with the fentanyl explosion in our communities and the fentanyl overdoses, we really just need a bigger impact and a stronger presence on the North Shore. And City of Hammond Police Department has offered the space to the DEA, and the DEA is now going to be establishing an office on the North Shore with us.
What difference, though, in law enforcement do you expect that to make?
Listen, the difference is you have, number one, possible federal prosecution. But first and foremost, it's manpower. It's, you know, a force multiplier. It gives us the extra people to be able to work the cases that we need to work. And we're very fortunate in this district, in this area, that we have Scott Perilou, the district attorney, and he prosecutes the narcotics cases heavily. But just to have that extra assistance and extra help is just important.
Do you have any figures on what fentanyl is doing in our area? For example, in St. Tammany, the coroner estimates that every single day, on average, somebody dies in St. Tammany Parish from a fentanyl overdose.
Listen, I don't want to get too specific on what the statistics would be. I will tell you, just in the past little over a week, we had two deaths that occurred due to fentanyl overdoses. In return, we've actually ended up charging the person who supplied that fentanyl with homicide, second-degree homicide. And that's part of this initiative that we're doing with the DEA, is as these people are coming in, they're selling narcotics in our community, selling these drugs that are laced with fentanyl, we're going to go after them. We're going to continue to be proactive in Hammond. We're going to push the criminal out of our city and put him in jail as much as possible.
Yes, that's a very surprising statistics on guns, illegal guns in Hammond, and particularly how many have confiscated from young people.
Look, we've taken over 120 guns off of the streets of Hammond since January 1st of this year through August. That's a lot of guns. And one thing, we also have a partnership that we've recently reunited or got back, reignited, I should say, with the ATF. And what we're doing is we're working with them, but we're working gun cases. And they've actually established a facility in Mandeville to where if we get a shell casing or we get some type of firearm, we can send it to their facility. And we have a turnaround of 12 to 15 hours to match a casing. In the past, we've had to send it to the state police. And when you send it to state police, the turnaround could be months and months.
Well, that'll make a big difference then.
Oh, it's going to make a huge difference on the leads for the case. It's going to give us more opportunity to pursue the criminals. And it's all of these working relationships that we need to continue to do and continue to have. And it's important that we bring them to Tangipo Parish. And in return, I think it's going to see great dividends down the road.
Well, you did not mention the big brouhaha, at least at the city council, over whether we should go in Hammond to an elected rather than appointed police chief. But it's certainly been a point of argumentation at the council.
It has. And people keep asking me, what do you think about the elected police chief position? And what I want to tell you, Ken, is it's not about me. At some point, I'm going to be retiring. And by the time this would even get in place, I would probably be retired. It's about politics. And Councilman Wells and Councilman DeVittoria, who just over the years have always given the police department a hard time. And it's always one thing or another with those guys, even all the way down to us trying to purchase vehicles to be able to patrol. It's just been one thing after another. Now they're trying to say, we need politics and policing. Listen, we don't need politics and policing. That's just the worst way that we need to go as a city police department. The city of Hammond sits in between New Orleans and Baton Rouge, two of the highest crime statistic areas in our state. And we have a great community here. We have a great police department. And I can't say more about the men and women that are doing the job. So in return, what they want to do is they want to make an elected police chief. We need to keep the politics out of policing, and a police chief needs to be running a police department, not an election. You know, their intentions, whether they have somebody they want to be the police chief or somebody they're looking to make a police chief, it's just not a good idea for our city. And once again, you know, I really don't have a major dog in this fight because I'm going to be retired. It's about what's best for our department. At this point, as the police chief, I can make decisions, and obviously our city council is willing to crucify me and criticize me and say whatever they want to say every other Tuesday. about the job that we do. What I'm going to tell you is our department is proactive. Our crime stats are down. People come to Hammond every single day. People come every weekend. We are just flourishing with people from all over the place that love our community. And the reason they love our community is because of all the fruits of what we have to offer, but also the safety aspect that we have, that we guarantee and that we give through our police department.
We also questioned some of those statistics on this subject, saying that particularly on the city council, they're quoting stats from cities that have appointed police chiefs, not elected.
Well, and that's exactly right. Councilman Andrews had mentioned, you know, I looked at the requirements for the police chief in New Orleans and Lake Charles, and every agency that he mentioned were all agencies that have appointed police chiefs. I'm not going to make a judgment on whether some cities need elected police chiefs. I will say that if you look around, Louisiana is one of the only states left that actually has elected police chiefs, and there's a reason. It's important that the mayor and the police chief jive. If all of a sudden you have two citywide elected officials, then it's a major competition on who's the strongest, who has the most power, and that's just a problem with that. The motivation behind this, in my opinion, is politics, and it's just unfortunate that they even want to get to that. It's unfortunate that they want to continue to do it. Over the past 4.5 years, Councilman Wells and Councilman De Vittoria, they've stirred the pot on anything and everything that they can find. Just recently, watching the fire chief have to argue over life-saving breathing apparatuses in a council meeting. That shouldn't be something that a fire chief should have to argue and fight for when his are outdated for his men. Look, we need to get past the politics. If we think adding another politician into this bureaucratic situation that we're in is positive, just look at our city council meetings. 4.5 hours this last meeting, and very little was accomplished. We don't need more elected officials. We need more people that are willing to stand up and say, hey, our police department's going to be proactive. We're not going to let you defund us. We're not going to let you get rid of our police cars and get rid of the things that we need to be able to survive. We have to continually progress forward, continually to buy new things. We have to continually to get new vehicles to put our officers in to patrol the streets. We're fortunate in the city of Hammond, since we got the raise, that we have more officers than we've ever had. We only have 2 openings in our police department when departments all over the state are struggling with manpower. And for us to get these new people in and then have to look at those council meetings and look at a council member questioning why we need 4 police cars, it's just unnecessary. It's a hindrance, and it slows down progress within our city and within our department.
Well, the other 6 municipalities in Tangipahoa Parish, all smaller than Hammond, with the exception, of course, of, I guess there are no exceptions, they all have elected police chiefs. But it's a dying thing across not just the nation, but the state. It's a dying thing.
It is. Listen, and Mississippi actually just had their law enforcement conference recently, and that's one of the big conversations with them. I believe they only have 2 or 3 left elected police chiefs in the area or in Mississippi right now. You know, and the benefit to the elected police chief is if that police chief's doing that bad of a job, and they can always get to the mayor, and if the mayor believes he's doing a bad of a job, then they can terminate. The mayor can terminate. I will. You have an elected official, then it's a lot harder. I mean, look at Mayor Cantrell. They tried to do a recall, and that just didn't work. So the thought that, if we have an elected police chief, we can get rid of him, that's not the case at all.
Well, in the meantime, anything new on the Mississippi Street drug bust that resulted in the shooting of a suspect?
Look, that case has been forwarded to the district attorney's office as well as the FBI. You know, one thing a lot of people don't understand and know is even though we investigate the case, we gather the facts. Once we gather the facts, we pass it on to the district attorney's office, we pass it on to the FBI. It's currently in their hands, and they're processing through the case and they're evaluating.
Well, eventually the body cam footage will be available, correct?
Look, as soon as the FBI gets through their part of it and all that, it's still a current investigation. What I'm going to tell you is this. That case involved a fentanyl dealer. A dealer who was putting out fentanyl, over 2,600 fentanyl pills, which could kill hundreds of people in our community. We're having overdoses every single day with fentanyl. This subject, he did not comply when our officers did that search warrant. Our officers suit up every single day, and they come to work with the understanding that it could be their last day. They're put in situations where they have to make decisions that nobody else would ever want to make. But our guys are willing to try to get in there and make those decisions. And they do that so we can keep our citizens safe. As I attended a conference this past week, or last week actually, in New Orleans, it was over 4 days, and I only saw 3 policemen. We have 11 officers working our streets in the city of Hammond. We're going to keep our city safe. We're going to keep our city proactive. I don't care what the politicians say. I don't care how much they attack me in a council meeting. Because you know what I care about? I care about the citizens that are coming to Hammond, that are spending their money here, that are enjoying their life here, that are going and eat at our great restaurants and doing the fun activities that we have downtown. That's what I care about, not the politics.
What else do you want to tell us?
Listen, I'm just excited about some of the things that we have going on. Our Citizens Academy is gearing up. If you go on our Facebook page, which is Hammond Police Department, Louisiana, you can get more information on it. It's every Thursday for 6 weeks. It starts in October. It's a great opportunity for people that have questions about what we do and why we do it and how we do it. They can sit through the Citizens Academy. It's 2 to 3 hours on a Thursday night, like I said, for 6 weeks. It includes a shoot, don't shoot scenarios where you have to make a decision whether you would pull the trigger or not pull the trigger in a situation. It also has a situations where you get to do a ride-along and get to see what these officers are going through. It's easy to sit up in a council meeting and critique our officers and critique our department. And look, I jokingly say, if I don't know how to run a police department, all I got to do is go to social media, Facebook, Instagram, or Action News 17 after this interview is posted, because there's going to be everybody telling me what I should and shouldn't do. And look, if all those things fail, I can just go to a council meeting, and Councilman Divitore and Councilman Wells can obviously tell me how to do it.
Drive with confidence. From routine service to complete engine repairs, you can trust the pros at A1 Quick Oil to get you back on the road safely. Drop it off or sit and wait in customer-friendly comfort. Behind Napa off Highway 51 North, give Bobby a call.
Here at A1, we don't work on cars. We fix them.